Assalamu alaikum students, I hope you all are fine and doing good. So this is our third lecture of social studies in which we are going to discuss about the major climatic regions of the world. As you know, climate all over the earth is not same. There are different kind of climates in different regions. The climate near the equator is very hot. The regions which are found near the equator experiences hot climate, and which are near to the extreme south and extreme north pole, those areas, their climate is really cold. So in this chapter we are going to discuss different kind of climates. The first we have monsoon climate. Basically, this kind of climate only found in the subcontinent. The location hai inki, that is in subcontinent and Southeast Asia, including Malaysia and Indonesia. And what is the basically the direction of the wind? It comes from northeast for 6 months. Northeast se ye 6 months ke liye aati, and then it's southwest for the rest of the year. And the southern the winds which blow from the south side, it brings heavy rainfall. Heavy rainfall, you can say approximately 400 millimeter per year. And vegetation is grown in such kind of area, that is thick and rich vegetation. Pakistan, you know, Pakistan also experienced monsoon rainfall, that is from July to September, and the most of the rainfall occurs in the north side of the Pakistan. And Pakistan receives less amount of rainfall in monsoon season because the clouds which are caused in result of monsoon, they cross the India first. So India receives rain first, and the rest of the rain falls in Pakistan. This is the reason that Pakistan receives less rainfall. In Pakistan, the average rainfall as a result of monsoon, that is 250 millimeter, and in India it is 450 millimeter. Next we have Mediterranean climate. So which are the countries where Mediterranean climate exists that are around the shore? The next climate we are going to discuss is Mediterranean climate, and it is said to be that it is the most favored climates. क्यों इसको फेवरेट क्लाइमेट्स में बोला जाता है? दैट इज बिकॉज कि यहाँ की जो सर्दियाँ होती हैं वो बहुत ज़्यादा सर्द नहीं होती थी, ज़्यादा सर्दी नहीं पड़ती यहाँ पे. दे हैव माइल्ड विंटर्स एंड दे हैव हॉट समर, ठीक है. लेकिन जो गर्मियाँ होती हैं वो क्या होती हैं? वो गर्म होती हैं और माइल्ड विंटर्स होता है. दिस इज वाई दिस प्लेस इज सेड टू बी बेस्ट फॉर एग्रीकल्चर एक्टिविटीज़. और ये जो मेडिटेरियन क्लाइमेट है, यहाँ पे बेसिकली हाई प्राइसेस जो हमारे पास क्रॉप्स हैं वो ग्रो की जा सकती है. लेट्स से कॉटन एंड फ्रूट्स इंक्लूडिंग ऑरेंजेस, ग्रेप्स, दिस ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ क्रॉप्स एंड फ्रूट्स कैन बी ग्रोन इन दिस रीजन. यू कैन सी दिस पिक्चर, इट्स बीन रिटन मेडिटेरेनियन क्लाइमेट इज आइडियल फॉर ग्रोइंग हाई प्राइस क्रॉप्स सच एज ऑरेंजेस. सो बेसिकली जो मेडिटेरेनियन क्लाइमेट है, द एरियाज विच वेयर इट इट एग्जिस्ट, दैट इज अराउंड द शोर्स ऑफ द मेडिटेरेनियन सी, द कोस्टल एरियाज ऑफ मोरक्को, अल्जीरिया, ट्यूनिजिया, सीरिया, टर्की एंड लेबनान. दीज आर द रीजन्स विच हैव मेडिटेरेनियन क्लाइमेट. And what kind of agriculture products can be grown? Cotton, basically it is a large cotton growing base. And you know that Egypt is produce best of its cotton, which is highly priced in the world market. And the fruits which can be grown in this climate that are grapes, citrus fruits, or flower olives and flowers. And in Pakistan, Balochistan is not a part of Mediterranean climate, but it produces large variety of fruits that has been grown in Mediterranean climate. Here you can see the cattle and sheep farming. This also happens in Mediterranean Sea, and the wool which is obtained from sheep and goats, that is very rough and tough, which can be used in making carpets. Here we have cattle. So these are all the characteristics of Mediterranean climate. The next we have equatorial climate. Basically, this kind of climate is being experienced by the regions near to the equator line. So this is equatorial climate. The kind of forest which have been found in this region is basically dense forest, and you know the Amazon forest which has been in Brazil. उसको बिलीव किया जाता है दैट ऑलमोस्ट हाफ ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑक्सीजन हाफ ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन इन द वर्ल्ड हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड बाय दैट फॉरेस्ट एज यू नो द ट्रीज एब्जॉर्ब्स अ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड रिलीज ऑक्सीजन एंड हाफ ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑक्सीजन हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड बाय द एमेजोन फॉरेस्ट विच हैज बीन इन ब्राजील. One of the characteristics of this area is that this area experienced 2000 millimeter of rainfall or more than it in one year. यहाँ पर तकरीबन साल में 2000 millimeter बारिश या उससे ज़्यादा बारिश होती है. So this is one of the characteristics. यहाँ पर जो humidity है जो नमी है हवा में वो बहुत ज़्यादा होती है. The temperature in this region has been very high as it is near to equator on which the sunlight directly falls. As you know, there is high rainfall in equatorial climate. अब high rainfall जहाँ पे होती है, you know that it supports the plant growth all around the year. बारिश ज़्यादा होगी जो plants की growth है वो भी हमारे पास ज़्यादा होगी. Basically जहाँ पे जो these regions have equatorial rainforest. And what kind of vegetation is there? They have dense, बहुत ज़्यादा thick vegetation यहाँ पे होती है. There are different kinds of trees that can be found in this kind of area. The trees which are found in this region, basically they have the height of 45 to 50 meters. What's their height is? Their height is almost above from 45 meters to 50 meters. And they have straight trunks or upper, when they reach to the top, what they have branches and leaves covering their tops and they are very thick. And the covering of that straight trunk is been known as canopy. अब इन दरख्तों की जो छांव होती है वो इतनी ज़्यादा घनी होती है कि अगर आप उसके नीचे देखेंगे तो इवन मिड डे पे भी आपको वहाँ पे ट्वाइलाइट का मतलब जो सीन है वो मिलेगा. वहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा धूप नहीं पहुँच पाती ड्यू टू द थिकनेस ऑफ इट्स कैनोपी. एंड एनिमल्स स्नैक्स लिजर्ड एंड अदर इंसेक्ट्स हैज बीन फाउंड इन दिस एरियाज एंड मैनी स्पीशीज ऑफ प्लांट्स हैज बीन फाउंड इन दिस रीजन. The timber has been grown in this region and this timber is of very high value able for furniture. Furniture banane ke liye this timber ko use kiya jata hai and it is said to be these are the most expensive woods in the world. These are the most expensive woods in the world. As you know, to obtain timber, the trees in equatorial regions have been cut down, which is not good. For as it they clear our air, they absorb carbon dioxide and they produce oxygen, so it should be banned. The next we are going to discuss is about tundra. Basically, these are the world's waste spaces. जहाँ पे ना तो कोई चीज़ grow की जा सकती है, ठीक है? So they are usually called as wastelands. So these are basically ice deserts with ice and rock. That covers about 10% of the earth. And basically, these tundra deserts, they are at the 10% of the world earth surface. And we have two type of tundra. The first one is Arctic tundra, towards the Arctic, the pole. And then we have alpine tundra, which is in mountains above the timber line where nothing much can grow. Basically, this region is said to be useless economically because आपको पता है कि इन areas में कुछ भी grow नहीं कर सकते, so इसका कोई economical फायदा है नहीं किसी को भी, ठीक है? Minerals जो इन areas में हैं, you know, जो natural resources हैं, they are said to be significant in these areas. But what happened in regions of Canada and Russia? जो कनाडा और रशिया के हमारे पास रीजन्स हैं, दे आर सेड टू बी इमेंसली रिच इन सेवरल काइंड्स ऑफ मिनरल्स लाइक ऑयल गैस आयरन गोल्ड यूरेनियम निकल. दिस ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज और मिनरल्स कैन बी फाउंड इन टंड्रा रीजन्स ऑफ विच कंट्रीज. दीज आर कनाडा एंड रशिया. एंड द एनुअल एवरेज टेम्परेचर हियर दैट इज -11 degrees Celsius विच इज बीन रिकॉर्डेड. Look at this. This is Arctic tundra, picture of Arctic tundra, and here we have the alpine tundra. You can see these pictures. And the only life that exists in alpine tundra, that is penguins. Look at this. This is the picture of penguins. And nothing can be grown in alpine tundra. And in Arctic tundra, the kind of small rats known as lemmings found in there. These are the only kinds of animals which can be found in both alpine tundra and Arctic tundra. You can see here. Next we have temperate grasslands. And what is the location? The location has been in Turkey, Syria, Lebanon, parts of Jordan, Iraq and Pakistan. So temperate grasslands are found in these regions. The amount of rainfall here is fairly low. That is about 250 to 500 millimeter of a rain year. ठीक है, मतलब कम ही यहाँ पे बारिश होती है, बहुत ज्यादा बारिश नहीं होती है. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ टेम्परेचर इज देयर? देयर टेम्परेचर इज रीजनेबली वार्म, एक्सलेंट फॉर रेयरिंग कैटल. दिस टेम्परेट ग्रासलैंड्स आर सेड टू बी एन एक्सीलेंट सोर्स फॉर रेयरिंग कैटल. लुक एट दिस ग्रासलैंड्स. एज यू नो, दीज आर द ग्रासलैंड्स विच आर बेस्ट फॉर कैटल रेयरिंग. Which are best for cattle rearing. And the vegetation is long grass here. You can see this kind of grass has been found in these regions. Look at these grass. These are long grass. And cereals like wheat and barley can be grown in this kind of region. So this is all about temperate grasslands. The next we are going to discuss is about the seasons. As you know, we have four seasons, that is spring, summer, autumn and winter. As you know, if summer has been experienced in the southern hemisphere, there will be opposite of that weather in northern hemisphere. So this is all because of the tilting of the earth, the characteristics of the earth that tilted around its own axis around the sun. So this is how we will discuss that how a four season has been caused.